So I got the rest of the soil and the nutrients for this bed, so I'm gonna start putting it in right now. I'm gonna finish it up.
And then I made a trip to Costco last night. They actually had some plants. So I bought this is a Mariposa plum, and this is a Babcock peach. So I'll be planting those two in the front yard as well. Got these earthworm castings from Costco, so we'll see how they do. I got a whole bunch of them. And I got these big bags of soil. But look, these big things of organic soil from Home Depot are from Costco, and these worm castings are from Costco, and these bare root trees are from Costco. And this fig tree is from Home Depot. So really I'm just kind of getting ready for this planting season, getting more than I need. My car is kind of like a clown car. Check it. Well, that's it. I can't believe all that stuff fit in my car. I'm gonna show you a wide view of it all. You don't always need a truck. Sometimes just use your car, but I love my Altima. I think I use every cubic inch of space in that thing to get this stuff here, because these three trees were in the car too. All right, look at all this. 8 bags of wood chips, 10 bags of soil compost, and 9 bags of worm castings and 3 trees. All that came out of that little guy. One trip. These are the worm castings from Costco. So we're gonna try these out. I'm gonna load these beds up with worm castings just to provide a lot of good food for all the cool stuff we're gonna grow in here. These are nice and black, as you can see. It smells very neutral. These are bigger bags of soil also, so that's pretty nice. I'm layering it with wood worm castings and then mixing it in, so they're all everywhere. I want to leave enough room on top of this where I can put a couple inches of wood chips to keep in all the moisture.
Now you don't want to mix the wood chips in the soil. You definitely just want it to be a layer on top. You mix it under the soil, the wood chips will actually take nitrogen from the soil instead of supplying it. If you leave it as a mulch layer, they will start to decompose as you water, and it'll basically like decompose into the ground, so you'll have to keep adding more wood chips. But that's wood chips and rock dust and worm castings and compost. Those are the four things that you just continually add every year. But wood chips are the key ingredient to the top layer, to everything below it staying moist. See how these bubblers now just barely pop up over the wood chips? That's what I want, because I want them to spray down and not waste any water. Got some other plants from Home Depot as well. I got another blueberry. It's a pink lemonade blueberry. We're gonna isolate the blueberries to keep the soil pH where it needs to be. I got two grapevines. We're gonna put these on the top up here so they'll line up in front of the door. I went to Sprinkler World today and I bought a whole bunch of all the stuff I need with the anti-siphon and a new timer. So I'm gonna set this up on two zones. I'm gonna do the planter box on one zone and all the fruit trees on another zone. And I'll be able to actually add two more zones if I need to have four zones eventually, because I'll have a lot more fruit trees up front. But I can just tap into that and add them later. So I like kind of like a little bit of a modular system once I get it set up. So, but the planter box is basically done. I gotta clean it up a little bit. And then we're gonna do some planting. So I'll come back and show you when we do that.